Hello, my name is Victor Goins, and I play clarinet and tenor saxophone. I'm a member of the Jazz at Lincoln Center Orchestra, in addition to being a director of jazz studies at Northwestern University. Today we're here to speak about a term that we use in the industry called doubling, a term that I don't necessarily use as much because I like to believe that when one picks up a secondary instrument, they should be able to play each one of them equally as well. So I want to encourage my listeners to be more proficient at playing the instruments on their own terms as opposed to thinking of them as secondary instruments. But doubling is a term we use in the industry. The first thing I try to consider with selecting my equipment is to find things that will give me the same type of pressure or requirement to put the same kind of pressure on my embouchure, from tenor saxophone to clarinet to soprano saxophone to bass clarinet to alto saxophone. The more I can get the strength of the reed, not necessarily number, but the strength in terms of how hard I have to bite down in my embouchure, the better I can get those things to be equal to each other, I think the better I will be able to survive as a person who plays multiple instruments to be able to get a good sound across the board. I don't want them all to feel different every time I pick up the horn. Obviously, they all are going to feel different because they're different instruments, but the goal is to get them to all to feel the same, okay? One thing I have done to try to work on being a better doubler is to practice all my instruments simultaneously or in the row. So I'll just sit my soprano on the floor here next to me, and my clarinet I'll put in front of me as well. I'll take the cap off my tenor saxophone. And what I did at some point in my career is I would line all my instruments around me. It would be sopranino saxophone, soprano, flutes as well. We're not talking about those instruments, but all of the reed instruments, I would sit them around me, and then I would pick up one and play a scale, for instance, on each instrument, the same scale. Then I'd pick up the clarinet, play that same G major scale. Then I'll pick up the tenor saxophone. Then I'll go back and forth between all of them, just continuously. You want to work on your articulation as well. I go through all of my instruments back and forth. I'm working on two things, and I want to be really, really conscious of two things. One is I want to maintain the tone on my tenor saxophone that I feel that I get when I'm only playing tenor saxophones. Because the time I have spent preparing myself and my sound on the tenor saxophone is really quite easy to reproduce as if I'm only playing a tenor. But now when I have to switch to clarinet maybe and do it, you have to make that adjustment in your embouchure. And I'm trying to maintain my clarinet sound independent of having to switch from one instrument to the next. I'll take the same thing and do it on soprano saxophone. So I'm trying to maintain the tone that's unique and specific to each instrument along the way. The clarinet should not suffer because of the saxophone. The tenor saxophone should not suffer because of soprano saxophone, and all around the board. So what we're actually speaking about, in my opinion, are two things. We're talking about muscle memory and the familiarity between instruments. You might have noticed a little bit earlier, I was very hesitant to use the word easy, and it comes from a philosophical view that was once shared with me by the great James Moody. In a workshop, I once heard Mr. Moody say, "There's no such thing as easy and difficult, only familiar and unfamiliar." So the ability of one to be able to switch back and forth between multiple instruments and maintain the sound that's unique to every instrument is based upon two really, really important things. First, the familiarity with the instrument and the sound it's supposed to reproduce. And two, good equipment. That's where Van Duren comes in. They provide great equipment that allows you to find the product that is right for you. It could be the V16 tenor saxophone mouthpiece. It can be the M30 clarinet. It can be the S6 V16 soprano. And there's other product that could be right for the performer along the way. It could be the Rue 56 Reed or the Blue Box Traditional or the V12s. There's everything for every particular individual. I'm sure you can find what you're looking for along the way. But when you have a chance to sit down and practice, you want to find the equipment that, first of all, allows you to do the job. And once you have the equipment in place, then it will allow you to take your musical skills to the next level by sitting down and not have to worry about using equipment that is inadequate. So find the reeds, find the mouthpiece and mouthpieces that will work for you. Put all your instruments down on the floor. Go back and forth from one instrument to the next. See what's going to work for you when you get the product together. Practice slowly, repetitively. Familiarize yourself with the equipment. Familiarize yourself with what you're trying to do. And I guarantee at the end of the day, it will actually help you be a better doubler, independent musician, whatever you want to be. It will make you a better person. Van Duren products, familiarity, practice, make it happen. My name is Victor Goins. I'm Director of Jazz Studies at Northwestern University. I'm a member of the Jazz at Lincoln Center Orchestra. I hope I get to see you and meet you soon. Take care.